Hi, this is Matt with Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff. Today we're going to be doing a quick video showing you how to install the wireless WAN card in a CF53. First thing you'll want to do is you'll want to go ahead and shut your computer down, remove all the power from it, remove the AC adapter, and remove the battery. To remove the battery, you got to flip it onto its side. There's a tab right here you can put your finger, your thumb in to, or any finger really, to push it out. And then once you do that, there is a switch on the bottom that you push, and then you can pull the tab on the battery to pull the battery out. After that, you have all the power from the machine. You're going to need to take this plate off here in the center. There's just one screw there that holds it in place, and then you can just pop it open. If your computer does not already have a WAN card installed, it'll have a dummy card in place most of the time, which if you look here, right here, there's a dummy card in this one. If you have a dummy card, or if you have another card in there, you need to remove it first, obviously. Just take the screws off that are holding it in place. And these little cables that are connected to it, you'll need to put those onto the WAN card when you install it. They just carefully pop off. And then you'll take your WAN card. In this case, this is a Gobi 2000. And you'll put it in the slot. You just slide it in at an angle, and then you push it down, and you'll put the screws in place to hold it in place. And you just lightly pop the cables back on. You'll hear them click into place as you put them on. It's not a very loud click, it's just a light click. Just be careful not to bend it. Okay, so they're both on. You put the cover back on. You put the screw back on to hold the cover in place. And then all you have to do is put your battery back in. Turn your computer back on. And load up your drivers. If you don't have your drivers or software, you can get it most of the time from Panasonic's, directly from Panasonic's website. Depending on which card you're using will determine which software you need to download. It all depends on the card you use. The Gobi 1000s and 2000s use a different software than the Gobi 3000s do. The Gobi 5000s use yet another software. The Verizon MC7750 card, it's a Sierra Wireless Verizon only card, uses yet another set of drivers and software. So you just need to know which software you need, which is determined by the card. Once you have the card enabled and the software installed, you should be able to go ahead and use your card as you normally would. One more thing, just make sure that your card is enabled in BIOS. To do that, just turn your computer on, and as you're turning it on, press the F2 button to go into BIOS. Let me try to position it where you can see it. And you'll want to check on the third page under Advanced. You'll see a option for wireless configuration. If you hit enter on that, it'll bring up and show you the different wireless options. You want to make sure the wireless WAN is enabled. Oftentimes, if your computer came with wireless WAN when it was bought brand new, it'll have the option there. If it doesn't, the option may not be there. You just have to enable the option in BIOS. And to do that, it depends on which unit you're using. For the CF53, you can often go down to the optional configuration kit and put in the right code, which is the code for the optional configuration kit to enable the WAN is 04, and then you would save changes and restart, and then your card would be enabled. If you have any questions, you can give us a call at any time. The toll-free number here is 877-202-7788, or you can send us an email at tech_support@bobjohnson.com. That's it for today's video. If you have any questions, just let us know.